So again, we're not trying to judge how a person lives their life truly. We're just trying to say, in relation to myself, I have a standard. Like, I watched this TikTok today where all the girls were like, this guy's such an idiot. I can't believe he did this to his girlfriend. The girl wanted to buy a stupid sports car. And he was like, that's the dumbest thing to buy. And everyone was talking shit on that guy. But honestly, I was like, give me that guy's number. How old is he? Because I think it's also stupid to buy sports cars. Like, what a waste of fucking money, you fucking narcissist. Like, it's such a waste of money. And at the same time, I don't really mean that. I think if you buy a sports car and you want to have fun with your life, like, no judgment. I just, for the life I want to build, like, why are we spending $300,000 on a car when we could spend $300,000 on, like, the coolest fucking house and farm we've ever seen in our life? Or, like, our child's future. Like, I just don't understand it. So, again, I'm not trying to say it's the objective good answer. I'm trying to say it's very subjective. That you have the options to live life how you want. You're going to die, motherfuckers. You're all going to fucking rot on earth. And no one's going to give a fuck about what car you drove. You're going to die. And you want to spend your limited time on earth complaining about women or complaining about men? No. Like, yes, if you want to, I don't care. But obviously, my point of being here and showing you this is to show you, like, there is nuance, to show you that Fresh and Fit are not like Andrew and Akash. But at the same time, like, you know, I wouldn't date an Alex who's just like a bitchy guy who complains and pretends he's woke and doesn't have an education. Like, no offense. He's not very well versed in, like, his own understanding of his own points. So again, I'm not, you know, I'm not saying these are good men or bad men. I'm saying they are not men who see the world through the nuance, like, lens I want them to. But at the same time, Andrew and Akash are closer than Fresh and Fit. And Ab and Preach are closer than Andrew and Akash. And Destiny is the same as, like, Abba and Preach. And, like, I'm mixing up everyone's names. And everyone has, like, a level of introspection in which, like, I'm, yes, keep going, keep going, keep going. But it's not our job to force people to keep going. And also, I'm sorry, but I've seen from a lot of people on TikTok, I've seen some from the bitterness from some black women on TikTok against, like, white women is so funny to me, because I'm like, it's ugly and you know it's ugly and you're keeping it up. And it's because you want to live in a bubble and you believe you live in this bubble, and black women have gotten shit for so long from even their own men that, yeah, it feels shitty. And it feels good to see Akash stick up for women and brown women in particular, because that feels safe. Like, I feel safe with the men in my life because they stick up for our women. They, like, you know, at get-togethers, how, like, in Mexican or Hispanic homes, in some homes, like, men are served first. In Middle Eastern homes, at least the ones I grew up with, like, you serve the kids first. And then usually my dad, like, helps my mom, or, like, the men will serve the wives, or, like, they'll serve each other. There's not a rule. It's about working together. It's a partnership. No one, my mom is not the submissive to my dad. As much as, like, Catholicism uses those words, like, my parents, at the end of the day, my mom handles the money and my dad goes to work. My mom also goes to work now because the kids are all grown up. But, like, without my mom's financial knowledge, my dad would never have even been able to retire because he was so busy working, which is a very immigrant thing. We work really hard. We pay for our kids, you know, whatever we're going to do for our kids, which my family didn't get college education. That wasn't something my parents could pay for, because my parents didn't have money until recently. And now that they're, like, one percenters or whatever, it's very funny to see, because, again, like, they just don't care about money the way these people seem to care about money. My parents just want a happy life. They want to have happy lives with their kids. They just want their kids to be independent and to live good lives. You know what I mean? So, again, how you're raised and where you come from, like, that's gonna move you and shape how you interact with the world around you. So maybe I was just really lucky, like, even though there were advantages and disadvantages to the way I was raised, it's just not like this. The way they're talking about partnerships, it's not like this, you know? Like, my parents are in love. They really love each other. And I'm sorry for anyone who doesn't get to see that.